Two men.
Well, we think we're men anyway.
Yeah. I was going to say it.
Oh, sorry.
One Land Rover.
And?
1968 Land Rover. Full tank of petrol and £10. So we had to get to Gibraltar in 10 days. So, 10 days, £10, full tank of fuel, two men. That's it, really. It was Danny's idea a long time ago, wasn't it? A long time ago.
About six years ago, roughly, he came up with the idea. But I couldn't find the right person to do it with. And then I stumbled upon Dan and I thought, well, there's nobody else I'll have to do. So we found him. And he's a brilliant bloke. And we met 18 months ago. And I thought, actually, pretty much the first week I met him, because he's brilliant improvisation. He's a great fella. And you can't do something like this unless it's... And absolutely bloody are. You can't... Flipping. You can't do something like this unless you've got somebody you can live with.
We started off in Hebden Bridge, West Yorkshire, with
tank full of fuel.
I thought I was starting it.
I thought we were sharing it.
Okay, £10, full tank of petrol,
and two guys.
And then people gave donations, so we got six Tunnocks tea cakes.
They were gorgeous.
Yeah, well, we've got two left.
Two left. You can have one later.
We finished the six bottles. My mate turned up with six bottles of Beck's, Kevin. And he also said that he'd pay our passage over on the Eurotunnel because we got talking. It was absolutely spontaneous. He buys tickets because he travels over a lot. So he donated a ticket for the Eurotunnel. And then we got £60. So people gave us. So it was fantastic. A friend of yours came all the way
from
London.
Friend of mine came up from Brighton. Brighton, yeah, and his wife. A lovely fellow. I've known him all my life since I was 12. And something like that, anyway. And he came all the way up, and he gave us a tenner.
Yep. And then other people kindly donated, so we got £60. So then we went off, and we set off, and we went to Paddy Doherty, and we picked him up. And then we drove from him to Peter Purvis's place, which is down south. Then we
went to Paris.
We got through the tunnel first. You were very excited.
I loved going through the tunnel.
He loved being under the sea.
Like
an octopus's garden, wasn't it?
It was fantastic.
And then we went to see Victoria Aitken in Paris.
Yeah.
Then from there we went down to Le Mans.
Sullivan from Brookside. Lovely fella. He helped us change a tyre. We've got the tyre outside, and it's got a bolt in it.
From there we travelled down to Salou, where we met Michaela Tabb, the snooker referee. We were there with all her guys, which was fantastic. They were doing a pool competition, and all that community of pool players was just fantastic.
It was for a competitive game.
They were all
fantastic.
There was no edge
to them.
Everyone was having a great laugh, and they donated lots of money. I forget what we raised there.
£300 or £300.
Yeah, and that got us through a lot of Spain, really.
And you had a lot of donuts.
Oh, yeah, right. I didn't eat any donuts.
No, I didn't.
Just been on water and bananas, mate.
Through Spain, more or less. Met Cheryl Ferguson. She was fantastic. She persuaded the hotel to give us a lot of money back.
Yeah, she did. So we only just had enough money to pay for the hotel.
We'd run out.
And then, for one reason or another, we had to stay another day.
Yep.
So we stayed another day. So we got the whole of the hotel for 2 days.
2 days.
For
free.
Nothing. So we made money basically there.
Went to your mates.
And then we headed off from there. From Valencia, we went to...
You say that again?
Valencia.
He says that proper, doesn't he?
Yeah. We went down to...
it's his birthday today. He's 45.
45, middle-aged. I keep looking at the camera like that.
It's
so
easy.
Used to doing it. We went to stay at a friend of mine's place.
They did a brilliant thing. Tell them about quickly what they did. They did a brilliant thing.
Who?
Your friends, fantastic.
Oh, no, in Valencia, sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah, I totally forgot. We went to see Susie. Susie Starlight is a friend of mine from way back when.
Absolutely brilliant.
This was before we got to the hotel, that's why I'd forgotten about it. And her and her husband, Scott Campbell, he's got an album out next month called The Knife. It's all about travelling through Spain and the kind of life. It's really folky, kind of bluesy. They use retro mics and retro... instruments. It was absolutely amazing. And they let us have a track from it called Dreamer.
Dreamer.
So we're going to use that as our theme tune.
And then we went down to somewhere else.
Then we went to the hotel. Then we went. That's where we had Cheryl. And then she was great. We went around. She busked and tried to make us money. And then from there, we went down to Benidorm where we saw Asa.
Yeah. Lovely fella.
From Benidorm, program Benidorm. He was absolutely fabulous. Yeah. And then from Benidorm, we travelled down, which is quite a long haul in a Land Rover that could only do 55 miles an hour. We stopped briefly at Malaga, at my friend's house last night, a quick pit stop. he used to live there, but he doesn't live there anymore. But he managed to, he guided us in, didn't he? About 2 in the morning, down the farm track. We got there about 2, got our heads down, and then left about 6:30
this morning
to come here, another 2 hours.
And then we just put the show together.
We've met Kevin Kennedy
and the fabulous Frankie Kokoza. So we've got to go because we've got the waiting, and we've got to get something really nice talking to.
And being in Gibraltar is fine because I used to live on the other side of the border, not far away, near Marbella, and I used to come here a lot because I think it's a cool place.
So you're quite used to Gibraltar?
Yeah, yeah, I think it's a great place. I just think it's very unique. You won't find another place like Gibraltar in the entire world, and I think it's great, and it's something to be celebrated.
Definitely. And what can we expect from the show tonight?
Well, to be honest, I'm not sure. I was just asked to do a couple of sort of musical numbers, which I will do. I think really it's one of those where nobody knows what we're going to be doing because we're actually filming it live anyway for TV, and the boys keep their cards close to the chest, so who knows.
Basically, I just helped them, like, just trying to raise an extra few pounds or... I ain't really done anything. I literally just walked around the street busking with Kev, so yeah, that was pretty much it. But yeah, some PR lady I've got, she is like involved somehow, and she just said, would you like to get involved, it's for charity and stuff. I was like, yeah, and I get to go to Gibraltar. I've never been here before. I didn't really know anything about Gibraltar. Like, I now know that everyone calls it Gib, so. And the monkeys got to the hotel, opened the curtains, and there's a monkey sitting on my balcony. I couldn't believe it. So shocked.